Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at how you can change your ActorCore character's appearance via Adobe Substance Player for the purpose of customizing the colors and materials for export into another target application. ActorCore is continually updating with new actors and motions, so be sure to check back frequently for the latest updates. The following workflow can be used with all characters since they've all been updated. Here, I'm just going to be downloading a single model first. In this scenario, we'll assume that we're exporting to Blender, so upon download, I'm going to choose a Blender Target Tool preset. Aside from that, you'll naturally need to ensure that you've also downloaded Adobe Substance Player. Finally, we need to get a hold of the materialmodified.sbsar file, which you'll be able to find on the ActorCore website. In your character FBX folder, you'll find all of the texture maps for diffuse, normal, ambient occlusion, metallic, and roughness. There will also be an additional two maps in the texture folder, the color ID mask and RGB mask, which are used to adjust material values for different assigned sections of the character mesh separately. In Substance Player, let's start off by loading in our mesh from the Scene tab of our 3D viewport. There are no materials assigned yet, so we'll need to import in the materialmodifier.sbsar file. Once we do, we'll see the parameters panel will activate. From here, we need to go to Materials, Character, and Edit, go down to the Normal section, and switch the DirectX normal value from true to false, since the normal axis direction is different in the two programs. You can change your output size to the value you want here. 512 by 512 can be used for optimized performance, and you can always change this after you've done editing for best quality visual output. Next, it's time to import the texture maps, which you can do in the Mesh Data section. The diffuse map goes in base color, and the others are all consistently named. You'll also want to enable the RGB and Color ID channels in order to import those two maps as well. That will enable their respective tweak sections. These two masks are assigned to different parts of the character. You can toggle the Check RGB mask, for example, to see which colors are assigned to which areas of the mesh. RGB mask is generally used for skin, hair, and teeth areas, while the Color ID mask is used for eyes, clothing, and accessories. In the case of this character here, you'll see that his Color ID map utilizes all six of the colors, allowing for detailed customization of more parts of the mesh. These colors don't include black, which is assigned to the base section. So essentially, there are a total of seven separate areas that you can adjust. Let's move to the character we exported and take a look at her Color ID map. We can now adjust all of the material values separately by changing the value of the various parameters. Hue and luminosity can be used here to tweak the color of the sweater, which was assigned green in the Color ID map. If we switch over to the blue section, which is assigned to the skirt, we can tweak the luminosity of the roughness and metallic values in order to give it a smoother, more leather-like appearance. We can also use the luminosity value to adjust the color of the character's skin more naturally. Roughness and metallic values here can also be tweaked in order to make the output more consistent with our destination application, if it appears too shiny or rough due to shader inconsistencies. This can also be done with the eyes as well, as you can see here. Because the RGB mask allows for gradients, we can use this feature in order to blend our character's hairline more naturally into the skin. The mask position parameter here allows the hairline to appear lower or higher on your character's forehead, while the blur value will generate a sharper or softer hairline fade. If you're satisfied with the appearance of your character, then it's time to export. Before you do, ensure that the output size is set to the highest setting for the best visual results, and then proceed to go up to the top and export as bitmap. In this case, we only need the base color, roughness, and metallic maps because these are the only ones whose parameters we've tweaked in Substance Player. The others can remain the same. Let's take a look at the character in Blender now. When importing ActorCore or Character Creator characters into Blender, you'll want to make sure that you've installed the free CC3 Blender tool. If you haven't done this, please check the basic Blender tutorial on ActorCore that will be linked in the description. If you import your character using this tool, all of the materials and texture maps will be assigned automatically, making things a lot easier. In order to replace the original FBX textures with the new ones that we exported from Substance Player, we need to go into our Shading tab and change the diffuse color, roughness, and metallic maps. Click the open image on the character diffuse map and load up the new one. In this case, it's called tweaked.jpg. When replacing the metallic and roughness maps using the same process, you need to make sure that the color space value is set to non-color here to get the correct results. Once you finish that, you'll have materials consistent with the ones you exported from Substance Player. A couple of notes before ending off here. If you want a faster workflow, you can also just use the substance parameters found in iClone without needing to go through Substance Player, in which case you won't need to manually map any textures. You can check out our iClone tutorial on that as well. Also, if you are exporting to Unreal or Unity, please be aware that the roughness, metallic, and ambient occlusion maps are combined in one ORM or HDRP texture. In Unreal, you will need to create an ORM map manually in your preferred image editing software to do this. There are separate tutorials on YouTube or Unreal documentation that can help you with this process in detail, but essentially what you need to do is place AO, metallic, and roughness on separate layers and isolate the RGB values for each one in order to combine them into a single map. You then want to load it onto your character's ORM map in Unreal. That's it for this tutorial, guys. Thanks for watching, and be sure to check out our other tutorials on ActorCore substance editing in iClone, as well as our forums at forum.reallusion.com. I'll see you in the next video.